Hello students, welcome to my YouTube channel for online classes. Before going to start this class, my dear students, I would like to make you understand first. What is my YouTube channel? You people are very familiar about my YouTube channel because you have given me good response in my first and second video, first and second chapter. Now I am going to teach you all third chapter, but look at my YouTube channel, Sudhiti Edu Talk. Sudhiti Edu Talk. Suppose that, my dear students, if you have not subscribed my channel, first try to subscribe my channel, like and press icon button for further notification and share your videos. Now, I would like to start my third chapter of the Flamingo book. Which book? Flamingo. Understood? And the third chapter of the Flamingo is Deep Water. First try to look at the name of the title, Deep Water, written by William Douglas. It is an autobiography. Autobiography means what? Whatever happened with. Look at, my dear. Deep Water, it is written by William Douglas. Whatever happened with William Douglas during his childhood, he wrote in this chapter, Deep Water. So we can say that Deep Water, this chapter entirely spins around. Entirely spins around whom? The author. Author means William Douglas. Now here is the question. Who was William Douglas? And why did he write this chapter? My dear students, William Douglas was one of the popular, famous Supreme Court justice. Understood? He got good name and fame. But there was a drawback. When he was a child, he experienced one of the fear of the water, aversion to water. He tried his level best to overcome his aversion to water, fear of water, terror of water. Let us be discuss. How did he do? What was his bad experience during his childhood? Which type of problems he faced? How did he tackle the situation? How did he sort out the problems? I would like to discuss. First look at, my dear. William Douglas, who was he? William Douglas was the famous and popular justice. Understood? And he got good name and fame. But during his childhood, there is a problem. Problem of what? Fear of the water. This chapter, Deep Water, it is an autobiography of whom? It is an autobiography of William Douglas. I hope you better understood. Now, whatever he wrote in this chapter, he wrote whatever happened with him during his childhood. And how did he tackle the situation? How did he sort out his problems? How did he get good command over his terror of water? Which type of method, which type of help he took with the person, with the people? He mentioned everything in this chapter. Now, there's another question, that Deep Water is taken from which book? Deep Water is taken from one of the famous book of William Douglas. The name of the that book is Men and Mountains. Men and Mountains. Are you getting my dear students? Look at William Douglas. This is the part, Deep Water, it is a part of what? It is a part of one of the book, famous book of the William Douglas. The name of the dead book is? It is taken from here. The name of the Miss William Douglas book is? What, my dear? Men and Mountains. I hope you better understood. Okay? Good. So, now it is confirmed. Who was William Douglas? What was his reason to write this chapter? Deep Water. Why did he decide to write this chapter? Because he would like to highlight, he would like to convey a message to the worldly people that how can we get good command over our fear. Fear is a negative word according to William Douglas. I shall discuss later almost everything. First try to know that. What is the reason to write? So, look at, my dear. Deep Water, it is taken from which? One of the famous book of the William Douglas, Men and Mountains. I hope confirmed. Now look at. Okay, now I would like to say to you, as usual, I have already means explained to you all that if you would like to understand any chapter, there are certain things you will have to go through. What are the certain things? If you would like to confirm rightly your chapter, certain things are, first you will have to go through the introduction. Introduction, characters, theme, message and summary, brief summary, vocabulary and important questions. My dear students, I would like to say to you that now I am going to teach you introduction. After that, characters. Then, means what? Message and theme. So, look at my dear. Introduction of this chapter means William Douglas, he wrote in this chapter about his own experiences during his childhood, whatever he got. He wrote about his fear. Means which fear he got when he was 3 or 4 years old. I mean to say what, my dear? The introduction of this chapter is written by William Douglas, and Deep Water, it is the part of one of the famous book of William Douglas, Men and Mountains. In this chapter, he wrote about his own experiences, his own autobiography, whatever happened with his, during his childhood. He highlights the problems of the fear, how the people think about the fear. They don't know that it is a negative word. It makes people paralyzed, and it is the hindrance. Means fear is a hindrance. Hindrance is what? Barrier. You can say the obstacle for what? Of our happiness and success. So we should never keep in our mind fear. Introduction confirmed. I hope that you better understood what is the means introduction of this chapter. Why does William Douglas wants to write this chapter? Actually, he wants to make people aware that if you think about the fear, you can never get success. You can never take an initiative action. For what? To do something better in your life. Okay. Now introduction killed. Now I'm going to teach you about the characters. How many characters in this chapter? Okay. Now look at the characters. And characters, these are the characters. First is the author. Author means who? William Douglas. I have already given to you. Who is William Douglas? William Douglas was one of the famous, means what? Supreme Court Justice. And he was a good writer, famous writer. He got good name and fame in his writings. He wrote so many books, understood, in which one of the famous book name is Men and Mountains, and Deep Water is the part of the date one. Understood? When he was a child, when he was at the age of 3 or 4 years old, he had gone with his father at California Beach, for passing his holidays, at summer holidays. And that, what happened with him? There was a sea waves, knocked him down means he was buried under the water. And when he was buried under the water, since then there was aversion to water came into his mind. So, what is the role of the author? The author means William Douglas, he wants to convey a right message to the worldly people that we should never think about the word fear, and we should never lose our patience. We should be always determined. We should keep a determination. We should be resolved. And we should be what? We should always think about our willpower, and we should make an effective plan to overcome the situation. Why? Because if we do not keep all these things, definitely we will fail. We will become the prey of fear. I hope that you better understood about the main character, author means William Douglas. Now, next character is a burly. A burly means a hefty, a very means what? Very matured. 18 year old boy. When I give a brief into means brief summary, I shall tell you all what is the role of him. His role is at only one place of at YMCA pool. Okay, instructor His role is very good. He is appointed by instructor means trainer. Trainer is appointed by the author to teach him. To teach him what? To teach him what, my dear? Appointed by author to teach him how to swim. How to swim. So if we talk about the author, if we talk about the means a burly 18-year-old boy and instructor, these are the characters of this chapter, Deep Water. I hope, my dear students, you better understood. Now, look at. If we talk about the places, these are the very important places you will have to note down. Take a page and take a pen and try to note down each characters and places. Understood? Look at, my dear. California Beach. California Beach. YMCA. YMCA, the full form of the YMCA, Young Men's, M-E-N. Yes, Young Men's Christian Association. Young Men's Christian Association. Third place is Yakima. Yakima is the name of what? Both city and river. And now listen, my dear. Before getting proper training how to swim, he went these places. How many places? These places. And what are the these places? California, YMCA and Yakima. After getting proper training how to swim, he went all these places for getting more experience. For getting more experience, he went all these places. The name of the places are Lake Wentworth, Trix Island and Teton Island and Conrad Creek Trail. Conrad Creek Trail means what? Another name of that one is the Midway Glacier. I mean to say to you all, my dear students, these are the characters. The author, a burly 18-year-old boy, one of the fit and fine, one of the well-matured boy of 18 years old, and instructor. Look at, my dear, places. These places, California, YMCA, Young Men's Christian Association, it is also name of the place, understood. And means what? Yakima River and city name also. These places, writer visited before getting training. Understood? I hope you better understood. Okay, now listen. I am going to teach you author, character, clears, places, clears. Now I am going to teach you about theme. What is the theme of this chapter? My dear students, you should come to know that if we talk about the theme of this chapter, writer wants to convey a message, writer wants to explain through his own experiences that when he was a child, he faced problems. Problem is what? He faced what, my dear? Fear of water. Because when he was a child, he went with his father. Where? At the California beach. For what? For passing his summer holidays. But during that, what happened? When he was standing with his father there, at that time, what happened with him? I mean to say what? There was a sea waves. There was a sea waves. Knocked him down. He was buried under the water. He was buried under the water. And since then, there was aversion to water came into his mind. I hope you better understood. Another thing is very important to you all, my dear students. When he was 10 or 11 years old, he faced the same problems. He was thrown by burly 18-year-old boy into the deep pool, miss what? Water. All these things prove that when writer was a child, he faced lots of the problem. He got fear and he would like to make people aware that if you would like to get success in your life, there is a need for what? There is a need to first get a good command over your fear. And how you can get good command over your fear? If you keep patience, if you have a good willpower, determination and good planning. If you understand the things, I hope you better miss what understood the theme. Now, my dear students, I would like to make you understand about the message. Through this chapter, the writer William Douglas, he wants to convey a message to the worldly people that he wants to give the clear message to the worldly people that if you would like to tackle the situation, if you would like to remove fear from your mind and heart, what exactly you will have to do? You will have to never think about what? You will have to never think about fear. You will have to never think about fear. Do you know why? Because according to whom? Because according to Roosevelt. According to Roosevelt, fear is, means what? Fear is what, my dear? There is no fear. I mean, so if you do not think about the fear. Understood? I hope you better understood. So, just try to think about the message. What is the message of this chapter? Understood? I mean to say what? All we have to fear is fear itself. This is the rightly remarked by Roosevelt. What is rightly remarked by Roosevelt? All we have to fear is fear itself. So, my dear, theme clear. I have completed your, my dear, introduction. Theme and message. I have completed. If there is any question, you may ask. Otherwise, look at, my dear. Try to pause the video and try to make a proper note. And soon, means what? You will be getting a link and you can download PDF notes of this chapter from Miss or my YouTube channel, Sudhiti Edu Talk. Now look at. Now, my dear students, I am going to make you understand the brief summary of this chapter. But before going to teach you brief summary of this chapter, there are few things which you will have to keep in your mind. What are the few things? The few things are that William Douglas, he wrote this chapter, means deep water, it is written by William Douglas. And deep water, it is the part of Men and Mountains, one of the famous book of the William Douglas. Who was William Douglas? William Douglas was, means what? Chief, means William Douglas, one of the famous, means what? Supreme Court Justice. Understood. He got good name and fame. And in the field of writings, he got good popularity. Understood. But when he was a child, he faced lots of the problem. Problem is like that. One of his worst enemy. What was his worst enemy in his life? The worst enemy in his life was fear. And what, my dear? Fear of water. Why? Because when he was a child, he faced the worst experience. And what was the worst experience? The worst experience was that when he was a child, he faced the problems. Problems of the what? Aversion to water. Fear of the water. He was buried under the water. Since then, there was a what? There was a, means aversion to water, fear of the water, terror of water came into his mind. I hope, my dear students, you understood. What is the theme of this chapter? The theme of this chapter is, we should what? The theme of this chapter is, we should always, means what? We should never think about the fear. And how can we get good command over fear? We can get good command over fear if we keep patience, determined, resolved, and have a good willpower to do something, to get a good command over fear. This is the theme. What is the message? He clearly wants to convey a message to the worldly people that if you keep in your mind fear, fear makes you paralyzed. It is a negative word. It always gives us what? It always tells us. What always tells us? Fear that you cannot do. So first remove fear word from your mind and heart if you would like to get success in your life. Understood? Why do you know, my dear? Because fear is a, means what? Fear is the obstacle, hindrance of our way to achieve success, to get success. I hope theme and message both clear. My dear students, pause the video and write every words. And now I am going to make you understand what? Brief summary. So your complete attention must be here. Each and everything I shall make you understand. There is a need to keep in your mind. Brief summary. Whatever we talk about the brief summary, you will have to keep in your mind a few things and we'll have to note down, because entire chapters depend on these points. First, you will write these points, and on the basis of these points, I shall give you a brief summary. Look at. First is, my dear, 3 or 4 years old, 10 or 11 years old, misadventure. And next is, appointed an instructor. Instructor means trainer. Next is, became an expert swimmer. Understood? Now listen. These things you will have to keep in your mind if you would like to understand brief summary. Understood? If you would like to understand this chapter rightly, listen very carefully each and every aspect I am going to make you understand. Okay? Look at here. When narrator was, Miss William Douglas was 3 or 4 years old, when he was 3 or 4 years old, what happened? He went with his father. He went with his father. Where? At California Beach. He went with his father. Where? He went with his father. Where? California Beach. He went where? He went with his father, California Beach. Understood? When did he go to California Beach? When he was 3 or 4 years old, he went with his father at California Beach. Here is the question, for what? For what, my dear? He went for California Beach for enjoying, for passing. For what, my dear? Enjoying his summer vacation, summer holidays. When he was standing in the surf, surf means when he was standing in, means what? There, with his father. At that time, what? One of the strong wave of the sea knocked him down. Knocked him down means he was buried under the water. He was only 3 or 4 years old. So you can think that, means what? At that time, when he was buried under the water, what happened, do you know? He, means what? He got fear of the water. Fear of the water means aversion, means what? Aversion to water. A-V-E-R-S-I-O-N, aversion to water. Aversion to water means terror of water. Terror of water. Terror of water means fear of water. Now, in the board examination, there are so many times it has come. What has this question, that when did writer get aversion to water? Or what happened when narrator was 3 or 4 years old? So what will be the answer, my dear? It's very simple. Answer is that when writer was 3 or 4 years old, he went with his father at California Beach for enjoying passing his summer holiday with his father. When he was standing there in the surf, at the same time, one of the strongest waves of the sea knocked him down. He was buried under the water. He was buried under the water. Since then, he got aversion to water, means fear of water. I hope you understood. Okay? So, first part is clear. Look at the second. Actually, as per time rolled out. Rolled out means what, my dear? Rolled out means, jaise jaise samay bitta gaya. I mean, sir, as per time passed. Piece by piece. Do you know what happened, my dear? He reached at the age of 10 and 11 years old. When he reached at the, means what? At the age of 10 or 11 years old, He decided to learn how to swim. Who decided to learn how to swim? William Douglas decided to learn how to swim. When did he decide to learn how to swim? He decided to go one of the safe place where he can easily learn how to swim. That's why he was guided by his mother. He was guided by his mother that don't go to learn how to swim. Don't go to learn how to swim. What? Don't go to learn how to swim. Where, my dear? Don't go to learn how to swim. Yakima River. Don't go to learn how to swim. Where? Yakima River. Do you know why? Why he was advised? Don't go to learn how to swim in Yakima River. Because it is very treacherous river. Treacherous means dangerous river. What, which type of river? It is a very treacherous river, dangerous river. There are so many cases of sinking came from Yakima River. Usse kya advice diya jata hai? Ki aap Yakima River mein tairne mat jaiye seekhne ke liye. Aur kyunki wahan pe bahut jyada wo bahut hi khatarnak dangerous river hai. Bahut se log wahan pe apni jaan gawa chuke hain. These are the things. I hope you understood. Understood? So, what exactly I would like to tell you? When he was 10 or 11 years old, he decided to learn how to swim and he decided to go one of the safe place. That's why he was advised not to go to learn how to swim. Where? In Yakima River. Because it is a treacherous river. Treacherous means it is a dangerous river. Understood? He was advised to go where? Means at YMCA pool. At YMCA pool. Where to go, my dear? Where to go? At YMCA pool. At YMCA pool. Keep in mind, at YMCA pool, Young Men's Christian Association. It is the name of the full form of the YMCA. And where is YMCA pool is? In Miss Yakima City. I hope you better understood. So, YMCA, Young Men's Christian Association, means what? See, he was advised. Who was advised? Arthur was advised to go to learn where? YMCA. Why? Look at region. Why he was advised to go YMCA pool to learn how to swim? There is a certain regions. What is certain regions? I would like to tell you. Actually, YMCA pool, it is one side 4 feet shallow. It is one side 4 feet shallow. And another side, and one side 4 feet shallow. Understood? Another side 9 feet deep. 9 feet deep. If we talk about the, what, my dear? If we talk about the YMCA pool, one side 4 feet shallow and 9 feet deep. 9 feet deep. Understood? That's why he was advised to go to learn how to swim. Where, my dear? Yeah. Means what? At YMCA pool. Understood? Next day, he goes with his water wings, other equipments, other things. For what? For learning how to swim. When he reaches there, do you know what happened? When he reaches there, what does he find? He finds that there are so many people are there. For what? There are so many people are enjoying. They are swimming with their, means what, water wings others. And he does not feel good. He does not feel good to be there because there are so many people. And he doesn't know how to swim. So he decides to go at that place to learn how to swim when nobody will be there. When nobody is there. Who decides, my dear? William Douglas. Understood? He decides to go in the during the afternoon time. When he goes there, he finds that nobody is there. The water, YMCA pool water is very, means what, quiet. And nobody is there. He decides for what? He decides what to learn how to swim there. When he, means what? When he was very close to the water. Do you know what happened? When he was very close to the water, at that time, he once again gets his old aversion to water. He once again gets his old aversion to water, fear of water. Who gets once again his old aversion to water, fear of water? William Douglas, ek bar phir usse kya mila? Old aversion to water, fear of water. Who gets, my dear? William Douglas, he gets old aversion to water, fear of water. Understood? So what happened, my dear students? Actually, what happened? William Douglas, Miss Arthur, he decides to what? He decides to go where, my dear? He decides to go at YMCA pool to learn how to swim, and when nobody is there, when nobody will be there. And when he goes there, listen very carefully, my dear students. When he goes there, he finds that nobody is there. He becomes very happy. The water of the pool is very quite still. And what happened? When he goes very close to the water, what does he find? When he goes very close to the water, he finds that what? He gets his old aversion to water, his old fear of water, terror of water. When he was 3 or 4 years old, what was his old terror of water? When he was 3 or 4 years old. Understood? So what happened? He decides what? He gets his old aversion to water, old fear of water. So he decides not to swim alone. Understood? He decides to wait the response of the someone. Why does he decide to wait the response of the someone? Because what? He thinks that, suppose that if he goes to learn how to swim, what? Somebody will be, if he sinks, somebody will be there at least to save his life. That's why he decides to wait the response of the someone. And he starts waiting the response of the someone. At the same time, a barely 18-year-old boy, a barely 18-year-old boy. What happened? Do you know? A barely 18-year-old boy means he came there. He came there. And what happened? He came there and he asked him, "Hi, skinny." Look at my dear. He asked, "Hi, skinny. Okay, so what happened, my dear students? Listen very carefully. When Arthur, William Douglas, he was waiting the response of what? He was waiting the response of the someone at the Miss YMCA pool. So here is the question, why does he decide? Already I have told you that he decides because he thinks that if he sinks, somebody will be there to save his life. At the same time, one of the Miss what? A barely 18-year-old boy, he came there and he asked. He asked narrator, "Hi, skinny." Skinny means lean and thin. Skinny means lean and thin. Lean and thin means वो लोग जो दुबले होते हैं, उन्हें बोलते हैं skinny means high, skinny means lean and thin. So what happened, my dear? After that, he picked him up. Who picked him up? A barely 18-year-old boy. He picked him up and tossed him into the deep water. उसने क्या किया? वो आया, कौन? 18-year-old boy. उसने उसे पकड़ा और कहाँ फेंक दिया? Deep water means pool के अंदर. I hope you better understood now. So look at my dear. Without any introduction, he was in sitting position and he doesn't know how to swim. Who doesn't know how to swim? Means narrator William Douglas, he doesn't know how to swim. He starts going to the bottom of the pool. But he doesn't know how to swim. He starts going bottom of the pool in sitting position. But he does not lose his patience. He does not lose his patience. He does not lose his wit. Wit means apt. W-I-T. Wit means apt. Apt means wise. Understood? Is it clear? And he decides. What does he make a plan? He decides that when he touches the bottom of the pool, he will jump from there. For what? He will jump from there. For what, my dear? To come out at the water surface. And he did the same. But what happened, my dear? Once again, one of the unknown power is pulling him down. Unknown power means what, my dear? Actually, there was no unknown power. He doesn't know how to swim. That's why once again he was going to the bottom of the pool. He tries twice and thrice to do the same. But what happened, my dear? Means His every efforts became effortless, means futile. His every efforts became futile. F-U-T-I-L-E. Futile means what? When? V-A-I-N. Means what? Without any result. Useless. Effortless. Understood? Uske sabhi prayas kya hue? Nirarthak hue. Understood? He wants to L. Y-E-L. He wants to L. L means cry. Who wants to L, my dear? William Douglas, he wants to L for help. But he gets nothing but water. I mean to say what? It is common thing that if you want to cry in the water, so definitely you will get to nothing but water. So he means what? He gets the same things. And he wants to catch something like rope and other things to come out from the bottom of the pool, from the deep of the water. But he gets what? He gets nothing but water in his hand. He wants to see someone. For what? He wants to see someone. To for what? To see. To take help from them. But he gets nothing but deep water, dirty water around him. Means his every efforts became effortless. So, what happened at YMCA pool when he was 10 or 11 years old? Misadventure happened. So, whatever happened at YMCA pool with the narrator, he was tossed by one of the 18 years old boy who was physically well built, and he tried his level best to come out from bottom of the pool. He applied everything. He decided to cry, but he got nothing but water. His every effort became futile. All these things are called misadventure. So in the board examination, means what? Such type of question usually comes that what is misadventure? Explain with the help of the given text, deep water. So you will have to explain the same things what I told you. Understood? And what happened when narrator was 10 or 11 years old at YMCA pool? You will write the same answer which I told you. I hope that 10 or 11 years old completed and misadventure completed. Okay? Now, my dear students, what happened? So, slowly and gradually, listen, he tried his level best. So, in the pool, slowly and gradually, he was going to be unconscious. First, he gets what, my dear? You can say he got H. Listen very carefully. A-C-H-E. H means pain. P-A-I-N. He starts getting pain in his, means what? Head, chest. Understood? And he was choked. Choked means unable to speak. He felt suffocating. Means what? He was unable to do anything. Understood? And at last he became unconscious. Unconscious means fainted. Means ant mein kya hua? Behosh ho gaya. And do you know that if a person becomes unconscious, he or she doesn't know what happens with him? So, koi vyakti behosh hota, usse pata chalta nahi kya hua fir. But when he came into consciousness, lekin jab usse hosh aata hai, when he came into consciousness, what happened, do you know, my dear? I mean, so he finds himself near the pool. Understood? And who is before him? The same boy of 18 year old. He was the same boy of 18 year old. He was with whom? The same boy of 18 year old. He was before the William Douglas. Before William Douglas. Understood? And he asked, I'm sorry. I don't know that. You don't know how, means what? You don't know how to swim. Who excuses, my dear? Means 18 year old boy. Actually, before tossing him into the means deep water, he thinks that he knows how to swim. So he asks him, I am sorry for my action. But William Douglas, he does not give him response. He at once stands from there and he starts moving towards his home. That night, he could not sleep. That night was restless night for him. He could not sleep, he could not eat. And he felt a little bit feverish, F-E-V-E-R-I-S-H. उसे हल्का बुखार भी महसूस किया कौन विलियम डगलस बट एट दैट टाइम ही वाज डिटरमाइंड टू लर्न हाउ टू स्विम एंड ही मींस व्हाट ही डिसाइडेड टू अपॉइंट एन इंस्ट्रक्टर व्हाट डिड ही डिसाइड After that night, next day, he decided to appoint an instructor. Instructor means trainer. Decided to appoint an instructor to teach him how to swim. Listen, my dear students, it's very important to you all. What happened, my dear? When a means what? Instructor was appointed. When he was appointed, he started listen very carefully and try to note down in your notebook that when narrator started teaching him 5 days. 5 days. How many days? 5 days a week. 5 days a week. Who decided, means who started teaching? Instructor. How to swim. Understood? And 1 hour every day. 1 hour every day. Are you getting my video, students? What I am saying to you? Look at the job of the instructor. When he was appointed by the narrator to teach him how to swim, he started teaching him 5 days a week and 1 hour every day. Understood? And what was his method to teach him? Listen very carefully, my dear. The method to teach him is that what he decides to apply a belt around his waist. He decides to apply a belt around his waist, attached with the rope. Attached with a rope, maintained by pulley. Maintained by pulley. P-U-L-L-E-Y. My dear students, I would like to make you understand Hindi that actually instructor means trainer. What was his method to teach him? What was his method to teach him? His method to teach him that usne kya decide kiya? Ki hum iske kamar ke se kya karenge? Ek rope lagayenge, belt lagayenge. Aur belt kis se connect hoga, my dear? बेल्ट कनेक्ट होगा रोप से और रोप किससे मैनेज किया जाएगा पुले. अब पुले क्या होता है तेरा ये समझो. यू मस्ट हैव विजिटेड इन द रूरल एरियाज. इट वाज अ टाइम व्हेन पीपल यूज्ड टू फेच वाटर फ्रॉम द वेल. जब लोग कुएं से पानी निकालते थे तो आपने देखा होगा जो जो रस्सी चलती थी जिसपे उसे हम क्या बोलते हैं पुले. आर यू गेटिंग माई पॉइंट? इज इट क्लियर? सो हु स्टार्टेड टीचिंग माई डियर इंस्ट्रक्टर? द मेथड ऑफ द टीचिंग इज दैट 5 days अ वीक, 1 hour every day, and narrator means instructor decided to apply one of the belt around the narrator's waist, attached with a rope, and means what maintained and means managed as per him and pulley. Understood? I hope you better understood. After 3 months teaching, how much teaching, my dear? 3 months teaching, understood how to swim. He taught every methods of teaching. Every methods. Who taught every methods, my dear? Instructor. Understood how to back stroke, how to front stroke, side stroke, how to swim under the water, how to swim miss upper surface of the water, everything. How to miss what? To whom? Everything instructor trainer taught whom? Taught the Douglas, William Douglas. Understood? One day, piece by piece, gradually, understood, slowly, he starts getting confidence and experiences how to swim. And he becomes, what my dear? One day he becomes an expert swimmer. Understood? Once when he was left by the instructor trainer in the deep water, he applied the same method. Who applied? William Douglas. To come out from there, and he successfully came out. When he successfully came out, my dear students, who successfully came out? William Douglas. When he successfully came out, means author. When he successfully came out from there, he decides to get more experiences. He decides to remove every types of the what? Fear of water, aversion to water, and terror of water from his mind and heart. He decides to visit at another place to get experiences. Understood? He decides to get another experiences. Means he decided to become an expert swimmer. So he decides to miss what? He prefers. And to visit another place to what? To swim, like different rivers, pools, and lakes. Understood? I would like to tell you certain names. Where did he go to get good confidence, to get good, means what? Experience, to remove his fear of water. I would like to tell you, listen, look at here. These places, after getting right, means what? After getting right instruction by the instructor to swim, he went Lake of Wentworth. Where did he go? He went he went Lake Miss Wentworth, Trix Island, note down in your fair notes. Lake Wentworth, Trix Island, and is what? Triton Island, Conrad's Creek, Conrad Creek Trail, Miss Mirai Glacier. He went all these places. You can pause the video. You can note down everything. Understood? So he went all these places. Do you know, my dear, what? For getting, means what? Better experiences. Understood? And he would like to entirely remove from his mind and heart. What, my dear? Fear of water. I hope, my dear students, you have understood the things that become an expert swimmer. I have completed a brief summary. That's very important to you. But a few things which are very important to keep in your mind. What are the few things? My dear students, actually, due to the fear of water, once it has come in the board examination, due to the fear of the water, what was the drawback in William Douglas' life? The drawback in William Douglas' life was, actually, he was deprived of fishing, canoeing, boating. Are you getting my point? He was deprived of what? He was deprived of these points. Clear? Okay, so I would like to rough these points, my dear. Okay, so what happened, my dear? Miss William Douglas, he was deprived of, due to the fear of water, he was deprived of what? He was deprived of fishing, boating, and canoeing. C-A-N-O-E-I-N-G. So if question comes in your board examination, William Douglas was deprived of what due to the fear of water? So William Douglas was deprived of what? Fishing, canoeing, and boating. Now, my dear students, I would like to tell you two important statements of this chapter. Generally, question comes, belly based question, long question of 6 marks comes, means what? Through the both statement. I shall tell you. First statement, keep in mind, according to Roosevelt, according to Roosevelt, what did he, means what? Told to the people, all we have to fear is fear itself. All we have to, all we have to fear is fear itself. Note down, my dear students, this is very important. All we have to fear is fear itself. Do you know, my dear, what exactly he wants to convey message to the worldly people? That don't try to keep in your mind the word fear, because it makes us what? It makes us paralyzed. It is, means what? It becomes the barrier, it becomes the obstacle, it becomes the hindrance for what? In our happiness, in our success. So according to the Roosevelt, don't think about what? Fear, because fear is a negative approach, negative word. It never makes us happy. It always becomes what? It always becomes the cause of our sadness. Suppose that whenever you are going to start an action or a work, understood, if you think about the result, so definitely you will start getting fear. So according to the Roosevelt, they miss what? Before going to do anything, don't try to think about the fear, because it always, means what? It always checks our way. Ye hamesha hamare raste ko rokta hai. How can we remove our fear of water? If we keep in our mind good patience, determination, resolve, if we are resolved, and if we have a good willpower, we will be able to remove from our mind and heart what? Fear. The last statement of this chapter, that's a very important to you all. What is the last statement of this chapter is? There is peace. There is peace in, there is peace in death. There is peace in death. P-E-A-C. There is peace in death. But there is terror of, there is a peace in death, but there is a terror of death. There is a terror of death, means there is a fear of death. What do you mean this line? According to the William Douglas, he wants to convey a clear message to the worldly people that he experienced both. Who experienced both? Fear of water and fear of death. Who experienced both? William Douglas. When he was 3 or 4 years old, he got fear of water, aversion to water, terror of water. And when he was 10 and 11 years old, when he was at YMCA pool, he faced what? He was nearly, means what? He was nearly to be dead. Dead. He was nearly to be dead. So he experienced both. Who experienced both, my dear? William Douglas. That's why he wrote, there is a peace in death. Everybody knows the bitter truth. It is a universal truth that sooner or later, everybody will have to go from this world. Sooner or later, everybody will have to go from this world. But people fear of death. They know that there is a peace in death. They know that there is a peace in death. But they fear of death. They think about the fear of death. They keep in mind the terror of death. These two important lines prove a lot and clear this chapter a lot. My dear students, keep in mind the value-based question related to this chapter are three. First is related to misadventure. Second is related to all we'll have to fear is fear itself. And third is related to what, my dear? There is a peace in death, but there is a terror of miss what? Death means fear of water, fear of death. I mean to say, in short, to whole summarize, I would like to tell you, according to William Douglas wants to convey a message to the worldly people that fear is a negative word. We should never think about the fear. It always becomes the obstacle of our success and happiness. And how it can be removed from our mind and heart? It can be removed from our mind and heart if we keep in our mind patience, determination, willpower, and if we are resolved to do something in our life. So, I hope that you better understood this chapter. If you have any problem, just try to go through my dear, your NCERT book. After that, you will come to know that every explanation I have given to you, questions I have given to you, I have already discussed to you. So, there should be no problem to understand. And if you have any problem to understand, you can ask to me. There is one thing, my dear, that's the last concept to you all to keep in mind that if you have not subscribed my channel, if you have not, press bell icon, if you have not liked my video, if you have not shared, try to do. Because this is the platform where you will get the complete solution of your language literature and you will get almost every type of the solution related to English literature, language and speaking. I hope, my dear, so you miss what? You better understood. Thank you. Have a nice day. See you next time, next video.